to Class 2A Girls 4x400. Any final comments on that race, gentlemen?
That just kind of went according to script.
Yeah, it really did. And let's start to finish. And just, you got four 400-meter runners that are as good as those four. Well, you deserve to win gold. So now we go to 2A. These are the teams involved. Lane 1, Trigo Community High School will have lane 1. Marine Academy out of Elbing is lane 2. Bennington High School, lane 3. St. Mary Colgan out of Pittsburgh, lane 4. Sublett in lane 5. Smith Center has a team in lane 6. Minneapolis, lane 7. And St. Francis High School is in lane 8. Among this group, best time, at least in the prelims, St. Mary's Colgan, 4:11.93.
And Bennington comes in with the best time in the state in 2A this year.
So Bennington is in lane 3, and Pittsburgh, St. Mary Colgan. Those two, I'll put a star by those two as we watch the finish of this one.
Yeah, it's going to be the gold of Bennington in 3 and the blue of Colgan in 4.
Now, as far as point totals are concerned, Ellis leads Oakley 47-42. That's first and second. Ellis and Oakley, neither team is represented here in the 4x400. Bennington, however, is tied with Olpe for third. Bennington does have a team.
You know, by using these three-turn staggers, we've eliminated a lot of collisions because previously the first runner could cut in after the first curve. And made a lot of collisions.
All right, we'll sort out the point totals as we get. Very important, last race here. Last chance to score some points here. And again, they stay in their lanes early on. Lane 2 handoffs, they will stay in their lanes. A 4x400 meter relay. This is girls class 2A.
Smith Center with an excellent opening leg here. That appears to be Tara Arnold for Smith Center.
Last meet of the day, last event of the day, means that entire girls will watch these handoffs closely. Concentration will be required as the handoffs are made and they're all clean.
And Bennington moving up into that third spot now.
Bennington is in lane 3. And now the stagger is made as they go into the inside track.
It's Smith Center, Minneapolis, and Bennington.
Trying to make that move to the inside lane. We are in leg 2 of the 4x400.
Looks like Smith Center stayed out in outside lane for quite a while before getting it.
Smith Center, Tara Rimple on the carry. Bennington is coming back. With Kim Garrett. Sarah Strathman ran their open leg.
Sublett in the lead. Megan Rice is the number I've got in the pickup of Sublett. Megan Rice, jersey 14-11. Bennington in second. And the third handoff is on their way.
And Bennington's right there on the shoulder.
Right on, right, ready to make a move. And there he goes. Bennington makes a move around.
That's Lauren Montgomery on the third carry. For Sublett. Kirsten Mears.
Sublett had a very poor handoff.
Carson Mears. Bennington reestablishing themselves as the leader here. Bennington third place in the point totals. They need these points. They are within 10. Within 12 of first place Ellis. You only scored 10. So Ellis, they couldn't catch Ellis. They can make a move for second here.
Who's just coming up in third place here?
Looks like Sublett in third. We got a new leader.
Oh, she looks great.
Boy, what a strong move that is. Yeah. Looks like Marine Academy is taking the lead. There you go, Bennington. There you go. Boy, the handoff's making here. Bennington leading. Marine Academy, Sublett there. Sublett third.
Marine in fourth. Or third, rather.
Boy, Sublett had a good leg there.
Good leg, and here we go.
Yeah, Bennington 63 on their leg.
Starting to separate out a little bit here.
And here comes Pittsburgh Colgan. Bennington on the anchor. Jillian Stratman. Colgan. They're coming back with Hillary Dickey.
Bennington's lead is now 20 meters.
And shrinking.
What a great lace she got.
Strong finish here from the second place competitor. down the stretch they go. Final 40 meters. Bennington is going to surge toward a championship.
Second place.
Battle for second is on. Second and third. Second and third, very competitive down the finish. Bennington, Trigo, Smith Center. That's how they labeled it out. 4:10.21 is the winning time for Bennington, who started in lane three. And what a finish there. It's our 4x400 in class 2A. Mark Davidson is corralling one of the relay competitors. Mark.
I've just got Jillian Stratman fresh off the anchor leg, and she brought it home. But Lauren, I thought, really gave you a good third leg to open this thing up.
Yeah, Lauren did awesome, especially since our first two, they held in there, but they did really great too. But Lauren really got it, brought it away, took us home. Her leg really did it for us.
Now, you had the fastest time in your class in the state this year. What's it mean to bring it home with the title?
Oh, awesome. It's what we were fighting for. We wanted first so bad because we're up there to medal as a team, like overall. So this was our goal. We wanted to get first so bad. And then we did it.
A team event may help Bennington climb in the team standings. Guys, let's go back upstairs.
Class 3A girls 4x400 is now 5:30. In this event, victorious team ran a 4:03.89 back in 1990. They're the state record holder team of Billinger, Kuhn, Pruitt, and Kuhn, two sisters. Olpe, Nemaha Valley, Oakley, Bennington, and Trigo Community, Jayhawk Lynn, St. Mary's Colgan, and Gossel, lanes 1 through 8. Fastest time in the prelims by far belonged to Bennington, which ran a 4:10.5, a 4:13.51 run by Oakley. So Bennington, the team to watch, they are in lane 4. And to lead off for Bennington, Sarah Stratman. To lead off for Oakley is Bailey Hembert. Also among those in this group of eight, Taylor Scheidegger, Dana Hermanson, Bailey Hembert, Katie Rydell, Morgan Eastwood, Imala Wittig, Jessica Harvey of Gossel. Jessica Harvey of Gossel, in fact, is a freshman among this group. First leg here, girls 4x400 meter race. This is class 2A.
In third place from Norton, Ashton Draper. In second place from Wichita Independent, Chris Speed.
Well, the staggers have changed here coming off.
In lane 5. There's your leader. Announcing Kurt Pauly as a gold medal winner inside the season excitement.
Lane 4 has got the lead here.
Lane 4 is going to take the lead. That's Bennington. Bennington is going to take the lead on the first handoff. Becomes Sarah Strachman, the sophomore, hands off to Kim Garrett.
About 62 flat for that first leg.
And Bennington with the lead here. Bennington has 29 points, so it'll certainly be pivotal as Bennington tries to pass Peabody Burns for second in the point standings. Olpe, which is also in this race, is in lane 1. But Natalie Coleman, by the way, is running the second leg here for Olpe. So watch for Olpe to make a move here. Although Coleman and this Olpe bunch back in the group a little bit.
This is where strategy in placing your runners pays off, because it's hard to make up distances like that.
And they very well could have switched that on who's holding the baton, but we were trying to inform that Natalie Coleman was the second leg of this race. Meantime, we go to leg 3. Girls class 2A.
About a 61 split.
And Bennington charges into the lead, had just a terrific handoff, no hesitation whatsoever, one to the next. And it's really paying off as she picked up about 10 meters over second place. Bennington's Lauren Montgomery there. Montgomery, a sophomore, running strong. 200 meters to go in her leg. Third leg, girls class 2A.
And second place from Valley Center, Joe Fisher. And from DeSoto with the time of 21.96,
you're going to the 140 meters to go. Bennington in the lead.
Not going to be much change in this lead.
Oakley trying to catch That's Kendall Marroth. She's a freshman on the third leg. Jayhawk Lynn in lane six started the race. They're now in third. Handoff, anchor leg. It belongs to Jillian Stratman, whose sister Sarah was the leadoff runner for Bennington. Dana Coleman from Oakley, and Oakley in second place. Coleman, the junior. Stratman.
Edgewood, she's closing the gap a little bit. I don't know if she's got that much to go, but she's closing the gap.
Anchor leg here, girls 2A, 4 by 400.
I'm not too sure she can do this.
It's getting close. Inside 10 meters to go. Here she comes around the bend, about to take the lead. Fans come to their feet here. Bennington had a huge lead in this, and now Bennington trying to fight back. The battle for gold, down the stretch they go.
Well, she's coming back, she's coming
back. And here comes Bennington's Jillian Stratman, and Bennington is gonna hold off Oakley. Bennington's Jillian Stratman finds another gear and comes back to defeat Dana Coleman on the anchor leg. Bennington over Oakley, and what a race, and the tears start to flow immediately. What a race that was run. It was Bennington, Oakley, and then Jayhawk Lynn. We're going to take a break here after this race, and we need a break. Need a race to rest on. We're going to head to more. The 4x400, we're back after this.
Thank you. 15.7 is Gina Lynn. And with a time of 4:14.15, Casey Britton, 43, Avery Britton, Patty Howard. For Bennington. So blessed. For Flally Madison. And now in third place.
Come on, Jimmy.
Tony Screensville, Collin County. With Morgan Houston on the carry.
Here are the lane assignments for the girls' 4x400-meter relay, Class 2A. The defending state champion is Bennington in lane 5.
How about Maranatha with those four freshmen? They have had a tremendous state meet. Seen them.
And all four of them are running again.
And all four of them are running again. We've seen them all over.
And Lauren Harrell won the 800 meters.
I don't
know. She's going to come out here and grab a leg of the 400 meters.
And I can't think of any other runner that we've seen from Maranatha. Any girls, have we, besides those four? They've been in everything and have been doing tremendous.
They're putting on a show here at the state meet. Ness City was second in 2011. And they are in lane 2. Lane 5, Bennington is out well. Danielle Ney, the sophomore, listed as their starter here in the first leg for Bennington. So running pretty well in lane 8 is Kiowa County. In lane 7, here comes Ellenwood. And it looks like it's going to be Bennington with the lead after the first leg. This should be Sarah Stratman, the senior, that gets it on leg 2 for Bennington. Again, Bennington, the defending state champion, they ran 4:09.54 in 2011. Bennington in first, Ellenwood in second. For Ellenwood, I believe that is Sophie Hayes, the sophomore. That's who they have listed here. But it's Bennington really moving it out. Sarah Stratman from Bennington. And she'll give it off to Lauren Montgomery. Actually, that's going to be Paige Crail that's got it in the third leg. She's able to get a look at her bib number. So she was listed as the anchor, but she's going to run the third leg here. And she's a good one. Now Maranatha's coming on. They are in third. They got the nice leg from Lauren Harrell, and it's Catherine Smith now on the third leg for Maranatha.
And falling way back to the back of the pack is Maranatha.
But it's Bennington that continues out there in front. They've got about a 30-meter lead. Celine is in second. So to anchor, this is actually Danielle Ney for Bennington. The sophomore will get the anchor leg here, and she's got a big lead. Aubrey Wilson for Celine in second place right now. Emily Hahn for Ness City in third.
Look at Caroline Bingham for Maranatha trying to get back in it from the back of the pack, really making a move down the backstretch.
Yeah, Maranatha now in fourth.
And it's just
Ness City in second.
About team points for Maranatha.
Bennington in first. Danielle Ney for Bennington on the anchor. And it's Bennington. They win the state championship again in 2012. Ness City is second, and here comes Maranatha. So it's Bennington in first with a 407.72. That's 2 seconds better than they ran last year when they won the state championship. Ness City in second, and Maranatha, those four freshmen show up.
And here we have Bennington in one, Washington County in two, Mohawk Valley in three, Bennington in four, Decatur Community in five, Pratt Skyline six, Greensburg, Colorado in seven, and Hampton in one. Mohawk Valley and Bennington running one and two. Bennington with the full turn around the race. That is Bennington. Erica Rottinghouse about to take over.
Now the girls 4x100-meter relay, class 2A. Jeff County North will be in lane 1, Central Plains lane 2, Ellenwood lane 3, Bennington lane 4, Meade lane 5, Kiowa County lane 6, Washington County lane 7, and Ness City will be in lane 8. Defending state champion is Bennington, and they are in lane 4. They ran 50-60. To win the state last year, and in the prelims they ran 50-90.
They've got Paige Krall that runs anchor for them. We saw her in the open 100 meters.
Bennington with a good start and a nice pass. Also in lane 3 running well is Ellenwood, but it's Bennington in lane 3.
Yeah, Ellington in lane 3.
Bennington in lane 4, I should say. Yep. Ellenwood is in lane 3. Ellenwood out in front as they come around. And also out there in lane 7 is Washington County.
Wow, look at Paige
Here's Cole. Ellenwood. Here comes Bennington. Bennington and Ellenwood. It's going to be Bennington, state champs in the 4x1 as they repeat as state champions here in 2012.
Wow, Paige Krall, the anchor for Bennington. The second race in a row, we see the anchor just come out of nowhere virtually and just runs everyone down for the win.